Hey, what's up? This is Doug with Design 8 Studio, and I am so thrilled to be able to tell you about the new version 4 of the Lowrider DIY CNC. This is a mostly printed CNC. It's the most rigid, most capable, most amazing Lowrider CNC yet. The gantry, the metal tubes, the steel tubes that you see that make up the gantry are purchased from Lowe's or Home Depot as 1-inch EMT. Now, EMT, that's a rigid conduit used for structural and for carrying electrical wires. It's very affordable, and EMT is sold based on inside diameter, but for our CNC work, we're concerned about outside diameter. So for that EMT to be 1-inch inside diameter means that it is 29.5 millimeters in outside diameter. It's beefy, strong stuff, nice thick wall, and it makes a great basis for the gantry of a CNC. The cuts that you're seeing happen here are being made in, I believe, a hardwood species called alder. It's a really nice wood, and it just has a dense grain and cuts really smoothly. The speed at which this is moving is, I think, 3,000 millimeters per minute. That's 50 millimeters per second. I think you're seeing a 12 millimeter depth of cut. That's a 1/4-inch, one flute carbide end mill purchased very affordably from Ryan at V1 Engineering. You can find his store at v1e.com. And you can also find the information, access all of the files and the assembly steps and the hardware bill of materials and purchase hardware kits from him if you'd like. All of that at v1e.com. No doubt there will be links to the printable files where you can probably get those at printables.com. I'm really thrilled to tell you that after months in the development and testing phase, that as of Tuesday, October 8, 2024, Ryan is transitioning this new Lowrider version 4 from pre-release development and testing to be publicly available. And I just cannot say enough good about this new version 4. The strength and the rigidity of the gantry and the machine is just tremendous. It is by far the easiest to assemble and build of the various versions of the Lowrider that I have personally built. It's just a pleasure to put it together. The design of the printed parts is amazing. Now, you see it here without any dust control in place, and that's for a couple of reasons. One is that in this early pre-release work, the dust shoe that Ryan has designed had not been made available yet. And for another thing, even if it had been available, if I had put it in place, it would block you from seeing what's happening. And we want you to see what's happening. Again, this is hardwood. I believe it's a species called alder, and it's a great wood to work with if you're able to get a hold of any of it. And this is a nice sharp bit, but you can see that the amazing speed and the amazing depth of cut that this Lowrider version 4 is doing is just wonderful, just amazing. I mentioned that 1-inch EMT forms the metal tubes for the gantry. There are strut plates, which in this release are called J plates. And those strut plates can be made out of 1/8-inch thick hardboard, which can also be purchased very affordably at Lowe's or Home Depot or Menards or any other home improvement store. But if you can get 1/4-inch thick instead of 1/8-inch thick, it's even better. And I was able to find nearly 1/4-inch thick hardboard by shopping for what Home Depot was selling under the name and purpose of wainscoting. This is a sheet good that's meant to be put on the lower half of the wall in a room, an interior setting, and beautify the room. And it's essentially hardboard that's nearly 1/4-inch thick. In fact, I found it in their discount bin and got enough of it that I could do the strut plates for my pre-release test versions of the Lowrider 4, as well as for my full sheet Lowrider 4 that I'm building of the final release version. This hardboard makes a fantastic strut plate. The EMT makes a fantastic metal tubes for the gantry. The YZ plates are 3D printed, and really the only thing that is kind of out of the ordinary are the XZ plates. And Ryan has laser cut aluminum, quarter inch thick aluminum XZ plates that he will have for sale. And I really recommend purchasing that along with a hardware kit from Ryan. In case you don't know it, Ryan gives the STL, the printable files, away free, no charge. He makes no charge to access the assembly instructions, and he publishes the bill of materials. So if you want to source the items yourself instead of buying them from him, you can. He makes his living on selling parts to support the machines that he designs, and then gives the design away free to the world. And I brag to everybody that he is a generous genius who enhances all of our lives by designing these amazing things and giving it away to us free. I have cut through quarter inch thick aluminum with my version 3 of the Lowrider, and many of the beta test crew cut through quarter inch thick aluminum in a single pass at a pretty astounding rate using the pre-release version of Lowrider 4. And there is a temporary strut plate that can be 3D printed so that you can assemble and use your Lowrider 4 before you cut those hardboard strut plates that I mentioned. And then you can cut those hardboard strut plates and swap them onto your new Lowrider 4. And if you want, you could even do aluminum. I designed this heart box with a very tight tolerance so that if it didn't cut right, it wouldn't be able to close. And I'll show you here in a minute that I was indeed able to close it, and it's kind of a satisfying moment when it snapped together, indicating the dimensionality was spot on. And I'm just so, so pleased with the Lowrider version 4, mostly printed CNC. An absolutely tremendous machine. This has been Doug with Design 8 Studio, and until the next video, I wish you happy making.